on the outside looking in. We don't have to let somebody go in for us. We don't have to send somebody in after it. But if you want mercy, you can stand up and boldly go before His throne. As a matter of fact, quit sending people for you. Quit just asking somebody else to pray while you just waller in it. Instead, open your mouth and let heaven know, I need mercy. I need grace. I need a miracle. Amen. Maybe the reason you're still waiting is because you haven't opened your mouth and asked for it. Maybe you're still waiting because you're still on the outside looking in, and God is saying, come on in. There's mercy to be had. There's victory to be had. You don't have to keep living in defeat. You don't have to keep living in the past. Somebody needs to let go of yesterday, because you can't get into where mercy is unless you're willing to let go of some things back here. Let it go. Move on past it and embrace mercy's blessing. Embrace God's blessing to you. The blood was shed for you. Receive. I wonder if all over this place we could stand one more time. I'm not going to go much longer. I'm going to keep you standing. But I just want you to right now close your eyes. Raise your hands towards heaven. And examine your soul right now. And find whether mercy is needed there or not. Find those areas right now where mercy needs to come in. Find those places right now where that precious Lamb's blood needs to flow. Find every hard place. Find every scarred place. Find every wound and let mercy heal it. Let His blood heal it right now. Find every bit of unforgiveness and let it go right now. For if you want mercy, you must show mercy.
Thank you.
Mercy may not be allowed to move in your life if you've not had mercy on others. So let it be our prayer right now. God, help me to forgive if I haven't. Help me to let go of those things I need to let go of. And help me, Lord Jesus, to receive mercy. Help me right now to receive what You have for me. Jesus, Jesus, don't you know that all of hell was against mercy. All of hell was against Jesus. All of hell couldn't stop it. And none of hell can stop you right now. If you're not receiving what you need from God, it's not because God is not strong enough. Like I said earlier, it's not that God is in trouble. It's that you have not allowed yourself to receive what God has for you. Lord, I don't want to be guilty of not letting myself receive all that You have for me. Somebody ought to declare right now, I'm His. I'm His. There needs to be a rededication in this place right now. Lord Jesus, help me rededicate my heart and my life to You right now. Lord, I've gotten distracted. Lord, I've gotten sidetracked. But Lord, help me to see right now that You're still there. You're still waiting. Lord, Lord, pick up the pieces. Lord, help me right now. Come on, don't be afraid to cry out for help if you need it. God, I need You right now. I need You right now. If you have a need, let Him touch it. If you have a need, let Him work right now. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody talk to Him. He just waited to hear from Him. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank You, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. where everything is unknown. I face the power of sin on my own. I did not know a place I could go, where I could find a way to heal my wounded soul. He said that I could come into his presence without fear, into the holy place where his mercy hovers near. I'm running to the mercy seat where Jesus is calling. He said his grace would cover me, his blood will flow freely, it will provide the healing. I'm running to the mercy seat. I'm running to the mercy seat. Are you living where hope has not been? Lost in the curse of a lifetime of sin. Lovely illusions, they never come true. I know where there's a place of mercy for you. He said that I could come into his presence without fear, into the holy place where his mercy hovered near. I'm running to the mercy seat where Jesus is calling. He said his grace would cover you, his blood will flow freely, it will provide my healing. I'm running to the mercy seat. I'm running to the mercy strength you need right now. Get that healing you need right now. Hallelujah. You don't have to leave this place without it. Come on, God didn't want you to delay any longer. Come on. You feel it. You feel the draw. Just do it. Hallelujah. Let God take care of it right now. Let's the ministry gather around and begin to pray right now. Hallelujah. I know there's more. God's dealing with your heart. Hallelujah. Oh, right now, let mercy flow, God. Let your blood flow right now. Let it flow freely, God. Come on, weights are going to be lifted in this place right now. Thank you. Dear Jesus, I pray right now, God, that you heal him, virtue, you touch him right now, God. Touch him, Lord Jesus, right now, God. I pray that you would heal that foot completely, Lord Jesus. That you would take every bit of pain out of it right now, God. Oh, Jesus, take every bit of pain out of that leg, God. Heal him right now, Lord. Let him feel your touch right now, Jesus. Let him feel your hand upon him right now. In Jesus' name, Lord. Let him feel your hand right now. Lord Jesus, I pray, God, that you would touch him, Lord. That I'll never forget, Lord Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, yeah. He's got a friend that's in a desperate situation. Needs God to move in his life right now, and has reached out to Brother Kevin. And I believe that God will draw him to salvation. He'll get everything he needs. Right now he's on a journey, and he's walking actually right now from where, Missouri? From Missouri. And he said that he would come to church if he makes it here, makes it through everything. Or just could get here, I guess. And I believe that God's going to make a way for him. Jesus, and I, when you do come in contact with him for the first time, I want you to bring him, give him that too. We're going to pray that while Brother Kevin's standing here, God knows where this young man is, whether he'd call a ride or walking, wherever he's at, God knows where he is. We pray that he would feel God's hand on him right now, and that there would be protection and there would be guidance, that his spirit would be lifted in Jesus' name. Lord Jesus, we pray right now, God. This young man, Lord Jesus, that may be very well completely alone, Lord Jesus. Lord, I pray that you would touch him on this road, God. Lord Jesus, that wherever he be, God, right, wherever he is, God, right, that he would feel your hand, that he would feel your love, that he would feel your awesome testimony when God completely saves and fills him with the Holy Ghost. Man, what a testimony. Hallelujah. As we close out, I just want you to know, if you've not been baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, amen. I just feel to say this, so somebody is here, amen, that you can get it done, need to get it done, and it is the only way. Amen. We must be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins. God will fill you with the Holy Ghost. Amen. You will speak in tongues as the Spirit of utterance. Amen. God wants you to have it. It's for you. Amen. Amen. We pray that God would lead you and guide you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Anything else before we dismiss? Yes. Hallelujah. normal, and God is really doing so much. We've been seeing miracles, we've been seeing signs, we've been seeing wonders, but we need to recognize them, give God praise for them, and then continue to pray for more, pray that God develops us into the people He desires us to be, and we'll see even more. Amen. Anything else for this?
I've got a testimony that I was going to give last Sunday, but we didn't have time to. I didn't speak up enough. I put an application about a month ago at City Hall here, and I put a comment on Facebook, which a few of them did, posted on it. Becky was one of them. She said she was going to pray for it. She felt there was a need in there and that promise. The very next day, I got a phone call from my old boss, and I was called back to office. The one thing I did say was enough, and I got that call back, and fluctuating back and forth from part-time to full-time. 2 weeks ago, this coming up Friday tomorrow, he told me that he's putting me permanently full-time, don't worry about putting me back on part-time, and that same day, he says that I got a car sitting out there if you want $600.
Thank you.
And the exact same day I come home, my apartment over here for $350.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. I get a couple of ushers to come. Yeah, Saturday at 4 is Diane's baby shower. After church, Sunday is Leah and Peyton's wedding shower. And that's what our mattress is.
But that's all.
So, at 6 o'clock, you have Mackie's and Marion.